Every year around WrestleMania time, I do a painting of one of the big, great rivalries happening around this season. And so, of course, I knew this year I was going to do Edge versus Randy Orton. This is the one that's top of mind for me, and I'm sure for so many people in the WWE universe everywhere. Such a dramatic return for Edge, and such a bitter betrayal by Randy. From Edge's point of view, from Randy's point of view, he was doing something to help out his friend. From Randy's own, I guess, warped, twisted perspective. This is obviously a very personal rivalry between these two, but it's personal for me as well. I know, weird to make this thing about me, but I've been working with Randy from my very first day with the company. We have a unique relationship. I don't know that anyone can really truly say that they're a friend with Randy, but we have a good working relationship. And Edge, Adam, I met him about a year after he stopped full time competing in the ring, and we stayed in touch. And he and Beth actually decorated their home gym with my prints, and we have stayed in touch periodically over the years. And to see the two of them now so fiercely competing with one another coming into WrestleMania, I know I'm on the edge of my seat, and I'm sure everyone else is as well. I think both Edge and Randy Orton have a lot to prove in this match. That Edge has to prove, yes, I really am ready to come back, and not just come back, but to succeed, to win. And Randy, who did something so vicious to Edge, has to prove that Randy was right, that Edge wasn't ready. Because otherwise, I don't know that you can come back from that, right? Like, maybe if Randy does win, it says something to Edge, like, no, really, I was doing you a favor with that attack. But I think that if he doesn't win, how do you come back from that? Only time will tell, but it'll be very fascinating to see. Recently, I've been adding a new technique to what I do with hatching with color. Traditionally, in illustration, you would hatch with pen and ink, but I'm using acrylic paint to hatch on top of watercolor that I've already put down, and continuing to find ways to push it even further, whether it's like cross hatching, or if things I'm doing in the background with this, if this is a wild spiraling grudge that's going on between these two. And so with this, I want a wild spiraling energy both through the background and in the strokes that I'm doing with the painting, trying to get that wild manic energy all throughout.